So, am I audible? I guess I am. So, let us start our session in Shaman's Club. So, today we are going to solve mostly signals and distance questions. So, we'll try and solve the most of them. So, let me start with the first question. Let me share this with you. First question goes like this. So they say sequences are having the same energy where x1 and x2 of n are the signals. So one second. So first question goes like this. Two signals. x1 of n and x2 of n have energy. Suppose x1 of n is equal to alpha times 1.5 for n equal to 0. The value of alpha is the keyword here is to take this into account, same energy. And this is the x1 of n and this is the x2 of n. So now we need to find the value of alpha. Try solving this. Try 1.2 to 1.2. I guess you guys are learning something in this week. It's not okay. Who taught them? No. Okay, let me solve the question. So, how do you calculate the energy of the signal? Suppose say x of n is simple. Energy of n. Is equal to root of n is equal to minus infinity mod of x of n equal to 1. So we have the signal x1 of n as alpha root 1 phi power n u of n. Okay. So now try calculating it. So now the thing is u of n is 1 plus n is equal to 0, right? So n is equal to 0 to infinity, u of n is 1. So the remaining place is minus infinity to 0. The value of u of n is 0. So 0 to infinity alpha square 0.5 power 10. Because 0.5 power 10. Alpha into 0.5 power n u of n whole square. So it's like n is equal to minus infinity to infinity. Alpha square 0.5 power n u of n. You know, n square is equal to n square of n. So let's have this new square. But u of n is equal to alpha square 0.5 power 2n. Wait, so we can write it as n equal to 0 to infinity alpha square 0.65 power 2n. Alpha square equals 0 to infinity 0.25 power n. So this is an infinite. This alpha square into 1 by 1 minus 0.25 a by 1 by 1 a by 1 minus 1. So alpha square is something but 1 minus 0.25 point something, so you will get 4. How do you plot x of n? It's like at n is equal to 0, at n is equal to what you have plotted. So this is root 1.5, this is also root 1.5, this is x2 of n. Then, so how do you factor it? Goes to minus infinity of x2 of n whole square. Point side of the square. Let's see what one point side looks like. You know that the details response like this. You only have it equal. So it's like you need to square it to get the energy. Since you have two impulses at two points, two time instants, it's not going to. That's how this number is. So you can understand that you have only 20 and 0 and 1. And the amplitudes are 1.5. So you have 1.5 plus 1.5, which is equal to 3. So finally you have 4 by 3. The energy 1 and energy 2 are 3. So 4 by 3 alpha is equal to 3. Alpha square is equal to 9 by 3. Good. it's not root 1.5, right?
It's just 1. It's just 1.5.
We got it. Simple mistakes. Is it clear for discrete time signal which we transfer is a large function with two poles and two zeros. Which of the following are true? First is this signal, okay, which of the following is true above which of the first statement is it is a finite duration signal. B causal, C non causal, D pure. There's a keyword here, so the signal x of n is an absolutely sum of the signal. That means absolutely sum of n means the signal is stable. Okay. जो फॉर्म ROC ट्रांसफॉर्म बनाई वॉट इज इक्वल टू वन इट शुड इंक्लूड यूनिट सॉरी so now that it is given the signal of observability system. So it's Z transform as a rational function of two poles and two poles. So it, but poles are like it is a 2G. So this is a circle, not Z circle. And the hitting a circle that's what a causal signal is, right? What if a signal is non-causal, then the RO signal will cover the interior part, the outermost pole. Sorry, in the most part, here the poles are the three poles of the unit circle, like some same modulus circle. So, it's like, region should be like this, such that covers the unit circle. Then only to convert the unit circle. But for a system source, if it is stable, then for a signal to be stable, for a signal to be stable, then it should convert the unit circle. Right? So that means the signal, given signal should be and non-causal because one day when it is non-causal, there is an error. Including the region, the remote most of the points. So, it should be non-causal signal. Is it clear that it is? It's an op-amp question. So there is a circuit like this. Kilo ohm. And there is a R here. And there is a 10 kilo ohm. So it's like minus plus. It's grounded. This is V naught, this is V. We are asked if V naught by V in is equal to minus 12, R is equal to 0. Try computing this. It's quite an easier problem. Make it just like that. Thank you.
cannot get the answer, it can help me. So within this concept here is, since it is a virtual op amp, is a virtual like, so if it is zero voltage of the inverting, non-inverting terminal, right? So the same will be here, but the voltage is zero. So at the op-amp is ideal, there will be only current which is being intaken by the op-amp. Right? So therefore, whatever we are doing here, current travels here with IP, and some amount of current goes here and some amount of current goes here. So finally, divided by 10k is equal to 0 minus, let's have it as b, 0 minus b1 by 10. This is a node 1. This is a node 2. So b in is equal to minus b1. This is the first equation which we are getting. Take node 2 at node 2. We are getting V1 minus 0 divided by 10k plus V1 by R plus V1 minus V0 by 10k is equal to 0. Anyone has got it? The answer 1k. We are getting very different. Let me see. Yeah, V1. Let's see how the calculations are going. V1 by R. So finally, we have V1 by 10k plus V1 by R plus V1 by 10k. V0 by 10k. So also, V in is equal to minus. Sorry, V in is equal to minus V1. So that means minus V in divided by 1 by 10k, 1 by R plus 1 by 10k is equal to V0 by 10k. Also, we have the information that V in by 10k is equal to 12. So, 12 by 10k is equal to 1 by 10k plus 1 by R plus 1 by 10k. So, solve.
something is not real with me.
Thank you.
sorry student, I lost the internet connection. So let me solve the answer for the question which I shared.
मेरे लिए गेमिंग में हॉस्टल खत्म हो गया लगता है अभी नहीं जाए कि अगर मन 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 इसमें एक्सप्लेन करो अभी भाई अभी कुछ किया अगर ऐसा ऐसे कुछ दस बार जाने
ఒమేగా t/2
ఐడియాలిటీ
ప్రిన్సిపల్ టేక్ ఇట్ దిస్ వే
ఐడియాలిటీ
ప్రిన్సిపల్ డోంట్ వరీ జస్ట్ ఐడియాలిటీ ప్రిన్సిపల్ t/2 its Fourier transform will be like in the omega term minus t/2 to t/2 a. I'm not worrying about the scaling factors, but I'm just worrying about the t process. So a t t/2 divided by t/2. This is how sampling function expansion is. So it's Fourier transform. So a t and the given thing is so it should be capital compare
okay.
So here the t should be capital t should be Fourier transform minus pi by 2 to pi by 2 and omega t. Up to this clear? So when this is all the other beta function p minus 10 n its Fourier transform is equal to question mark. Usually, sorry, sigma is equal to n is equal to question mark. So n is equal to minus n, delta of 10 t minus n t is its Fourier transform is minus sigma delta s minus k f s, where k is going to to minus
infinity.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
So this is how it should be. So here P is equals is nothing but 100
meters.
So the impulse response of N into
P is
nothing but 10. So effort should be not when it comes to the Nyquist frequency computation. So delta of F minus K into P.
Right.
So you have something like this in the spacing
like
0.1, because delta is now equal to 1 in the frequencies k point k is equal to plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2 like that. But this is a frequency. So now we have convolution in time delta. So when you convert it to the x1 of f into x2 of f, where this is x1 of t and this is x2 of t. So this is in omega, we have it to put omega delta. So now we need to convert this to the frequency. So how will you do that? Minus pi by 2 into 4 pi, so 1 by 4 to 1 by 4 frequency. So this is x1 of f for sine pi t by pi by 2 t, and now second number scaling factor. Only this I took. This one, it's like just a scaling amplification. So I am working with that. So this is x2 of f, this is x1 of f. You have something like this. So when you multiply it, what do you get? The same impulses, minus 0.1, 0.2, minus 0.4. Now this is the final. What are the values that we can suspect? If max is equal to twice of max, it is equal to 4. Got it? Can I get a response? This is kind of a tricky question. It should be a thorough in our for everyone. Thanks for coming. Okay. So we'll move on to the next question. So next question is something like this. probably going to be a function. How will you calculate the variance? So one thing to notice here is this is obvious an odd function. I'm sorry, an even function. This is an odd function. Because it goes to an odd function. This is an even function. The even and the odd function means an odd function. If you see, you have something like this. This is an odd function, right? So if you integrate from minus infinity, you will sum up the integers, which will give you 0. So this is equal to 0. So expectation of x squared is goes to minus infinity, x squared into mod x, fx of x. So this will be
125 x cross x e power minus x dx. So you see, this is a linear form of, this is an even function. Total function is even function, and this is a Bessel function. So when we say Bessel function definition, you get the answer to be 6. It's a long derivation which I'll continue in the next, like I'll tell you in the next class, but for now it's just a homework for you to how to compute the answer for this. How will you do this? Because this Bessel function, using this Bessel function, gamma function, everything is it's very important. So I'm writing the answer directly now, but I want you guys to do a homework on this. It's quite simple, that you just go into the form and substitute the values and find out how this 6 has come. This is small homework which I want to give you, because I don't want to reveal this now in this class. So by using Bessel function, you will have the answer to the 6. Try finding it out. How this is. Like even after this class, you can try finding it. I don't have, I'll ask you in the next class about how you I'll give you the solving problem. We will solve in the next session. Okay? So try solving this question. So two homeworks are going to be good. It's like you first find out how 6 has come. The answer is 6. But how can you do this? How can you integrate the whole function? Find it out. The other question goes like this. X of n is equal to 1 plus cos pi by 8n is the periodic signal with period 16. VFS coefficient are defined by AK is equal to 1 by 16. Sigma n is equal to 0 to 50 x of n e power minus n pi by n k n for all. What is the coefficient? A plus k 1 is equal to 1. I don't think I'll solve this question before. So try solving this as a problem. Copy it down. Try solving this. Next class I want to ask for this, for the A problem question, as well as how Bessel function is. We'll meet in the next class for the two solutions and close to homework. We should have solved it. We are expected to come in the next class. Thank you for joining today's class.
the meat on it.